Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and today I wanted to make a quick video talking about the valve guides and valve seals on this big block Chevy head for a 396 that I'm putting together. And the reason why I wanted to make this video is when I was going through the process to modify this head, I had a couple questions, and no matter how much I searched the internet, how many articles I read, none of them answered my questions. So I wanted to go ahead and make this video so it covers the questions that I had, answers them for you guys, so you guys are a little bit better informed and don't have to wonder like I did. Now, these heads are relatively stock besides a little bit of porting. They're still using the stock valve guides. Most of you guys know stock big block Chevys run these umbrella valve guide seals, and they're terrible. You'd be lucky to find a set of these in a performance application these days. There's so many better options. Now, up and before the point where I modified this head, I was running these rubber valve guide seals that have a Teflon ring in the center, and they will slide over your stock guides. So they slid onto a stock head, much better than the umbrella, but still not a great solution. And ultimately, I prefer to run Viton valve seals, and these are a lot smaller in diameter, and they just do a much, much better job of sealing the valve stems. Now, I have found that you can get Viton valve stem seals for the stock guides on big block Chevy heads. But my problem arose when I was doing a camshaft upgrade. I was switching from my hydraulic flat-tappet camshaft that was running about 550,000 lift to a solid roller that had about 640,000 lift. Now, this posed two problems. The first problem, which was very obvious, was the valve seals did not provide enough clearance for the valve springs, because I had to upgrade from single valve springs to dual valve springs. And with the extra spring in the center, with the dampener, they were hitting the valve guide. So it was clear that I needed a narrower or smaller valve stem seal. The next problem was with gaining almost 100,000ths of lift in the camshaft, the top of the keeper and retainer were making contact with the top of the valve guide, which kind of made me realize as I looked through most of the mild cams that you see for a stock big block Chevy that have, you know, a hydraulic flat tappet, essentially they all stop around a 550,000ths lift, which now made sense to me because then I'm realizing the stock heads can't really take much more lift than that. So in order to run this cam, I was going to have to cut my guides down. Now, I easily could have taken them to a machine shop and had all this work done, but I'm more of a do-it-yourselfer and wanted to do it at home. So I knew that they offered these valve guide cutters on the internet, and you go ahead and pick what size arbor you need and what size chuck on the outside for the outside diameter of your valve seal. Now, I knew that this would go ahead and cut down my valve guides so I could, you know, to 500,000ths to fit this Viton seal, which is smaller in outside diameter and will allow me to run a triple valve spring, but also seals the valve much, much better. But that only fixed the diameter problem and would let me run the bigger valve springs. I still had the height problem. And no matter how much looking I did, I could not find any information if these cutters actually go ahead and cut down the height of the top of the valve guide. So I have this valve guide here, and I've already done all of them and cut them all down, but they were substantially higher. So I went into this thinking I'd just order the tool, I'd be able to cut down the outside diameter of the valve guide, and if it didn't address the height, I would have, you know, worked on that problem if it arose. But in the end, this cutter does have an extra cutter right here at the top, which did cut down the top of the valve guide and put this nice chamfer on it so the valve seal slides on. So I did have to do quite a bit of measuring across all of them, and I had to mock everything up with my valves, my keeper and retainer, and the valve seals and measure how much I needed to cut down on each particular valve guide so that way I had enough room for the lift that I was running. I was able to just do it with a hand drill very carefully and slowly, and it worked great, honestly. I was able to get all these machined down, and I was able to put this head back together, and I've ran it for a while with this cut down. I'm just now have the engine apart and I'm refreshing it, so while it's apart now, I'm just taking advantage of making this video to explain this to you guys. Like I said, the tool's about under $100. It effortlessly did both sets of heads and has plenty of life for more. But I wanted to make this video real quick so you guys have this as a resource so you don't wonder like I did. on not only it cutting down the valve diameter, but the height. That way you're not limited to the stock size cams. You know, like I said, you look at most moderate hydraulic flat tappet cams for a big block Chevy, the lift almost always stops around 550 thousandths. That's because of the valve guides. It's not really that well documented, but you get a cutter like this, you can cut your guides down and it'll allow you to open up a whole new opportunity of cam choices. So that's all I have on that, guys. Thanks for taking the time to watch the video. Please check out my channel for more videos of other tech and other projects I got going on. Thanks for watching.